What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Daily here from Nation Fusion, and today I have a review for you for Vengeance. Vengeance is a first-person shooter, and that's it. That's the review. Thanks for watching. Vengeance suffers from being too normal. It is a bland, normal-looking first-person shooter with generic bad shooter guys with ski masks and helmets, a generic range of weapons that you can find in any other game across Steam or your PlayStation, Xbox, anything like that. You can find this game in better or worse formations all across the internet, from free-to-play games all the way to, you know, $20 or $30 titles. Vengeance is just your average first-person shooter. And it actually created some pretty hilarious moments just because of how not ready it is for public consumption. So to start off, this game you play as either a mercenary or some kind of other military guy. I'm not familiar with the acronyms that the person's using for this. However, they do have an American soldier right there on like the splash art, but it's not actually in the game. I don't know. I couldn't tell you. In any case, you have some generic weapon customization, scopes and attachments, things of that nature. The game features two offline modes, a regular kind of like wave survival where you're clearing out waves of enemies and then using the money that you gain from clearing each wave to purchase better weapons and ammunition to survive the next wave, and you can kind of see how far you can get. The other mode is the exact same thing as that mode, however, instead of fighting regular bad guys, you're now fighting a random asset flip of just random zombies. You'll see zombies in there that look like Slenderman. You'll see like zombies in there that are just regular people. And then most famously, one where I actually had to stop my recording because I was laughing so hard, a zombie that is a small Girl Scout with a huge broadsword on her back. Yeah, like the girls that sell Girl Scout cookies. It's one of those, and she has a big sword on her back. I don't know where you get an asset like that from, and I kind of don't want to know. So, besides those two modes, it does have a multiplayer, and for the purposes of review, I had to go in and check the multiplayer. Surely there would be nobody playing. It would just be absolutely empty. No, I found a full room of like 10 people playing this broken-ass game, and there was all sorts of crazy lag. I got stuck on benches and objects, and the developer was actually playing the game as well. He was in there, and I literally was ending every round with just hysterical laughter when I was recording this gameplay. It was absolutely hilarious to see these guys in here playing. On the multiplayer side of things, you got a couple of different game modes. You have a kind of team deathmatch. You have a regular type of just individual deathmatch, and then you also have a kind of gun game where you progress through the weapons in the game. Now, on a side note, I don't know if I can give credit to the developer for this. I will if it was in fact their work. But there were some pretty cool animations in the game. The reloads, the sounds were okay at certain instances and points. The soundtrack itself is absolutely terrible. There's only like one or two songs in the game and they loop constantly. But some of like the weapon sounds and the reloading sounds were okay. But I have a very, very funny feeling that those are not from the actual developer and they're probably store-bought assets as well. So, I mean, overall, can I recommend Vengeance for you? I don't know. Let's hop onto Google and see how much this thing costs, because I have a feeling it's going to be way too much money for what it is. Let's see, Vengeance on Steam. It's $9.99. Please go spend that money on a pizza and don't pay over 99 cents for this game. The final verdict for Vengeance is going to be an abysmal 3 out of 10. It gets a couple of points for trying and there being people actually on playing this one. They have a kind of comprehensive trailer on the Steam storefront page. It does have some positive reviews, but I have a very funny feeling that those reviews are for free Steam codes. I can't outright say that's exactly what it is. You know, if you're looking for a mindless first-person shooter and you want to waste 10 of your dollars, then maybe go ahead and pick this game up. If not, play something else, please, for God's sakes, because this is not good.